Hello and welcome back to Mastering IT. This video is simply part of a basic networking course that we started 10 videos ago. Today we're going to talk about the different types of communications in network, so be prepared. Let's start with the topic of today. In networks, the devices can communicate in three ways: one-to-one, one-to-a-group, and one-to-all. But let's see how each type of communication is called. The first one is called unicast communication. In this type of communication, one single device is receiving and sending packets to one single device. So, here we can have a bidirectional communication, but between two single devices. Now, in this type of communication, network devices use only a specific type of IP address. What type of IP address? Well, we can have whatever IP address in the range of class A to class C. We already talked about classes of IP addresses in the last two videos. Have you watched them? Now, the next type of communication is multicast communication. In this type of communication, a single device can communicate with a group of devices in your network, but not with all of them. When a single device wants to communicate with a group, it must use a specific type of IP address in order to achieve it. What type of IP addresses can we use in multicast communication? Well, we must use only class D IP addresses in this type of communication. And finally, the broadcast communication. When a device sends a broadcast, it's because it wants to communicate with all the devices in the network. This means that if you send a broadcast, every single device in the same network will receive that broadcast. Now, do you want to know the type of IP addresses used in this type of communication? Well, you must use the last IP address in your IP network to send a broadcast. I know that we haven't talked about IP networks and subnetting yet, and maybe only knowing that, you will be able to note which is the last IP address in your network or in your subnetwork. Subnetting is a topic that requires a lot of information and practice, so I plan to create a specific course for that. For now, just keep in mind that the last IP address in your network is used to send a broadcast. Okay, here we have an example network. We are going to use it to see some examples of communications based on the topics discussed before. When can we use the unicast communication? The major part of the time, the devices can communicate one-to-one. For example, when Peter in the IP department sends an email to Robert in the HR department, or when you search the web to watch your favorite movie online, or even when you chat with your mother using social media, etc. All of those are unicast communication.
Multicast examples. Sometimes we need to communicate with many people at the same time in the company. For example, when doing video conference, when you play online games in groups, when you make a group call, etc. All of those are examples of multicast communication.
And finally, the broadcast communication example. This type of communication is basically used for networking protocols. Network protocols use broadcast communication to do some specific tasks. But this is something out of the scope of this basic course. Remember that if you need to know much more about networks, you can win an intensive networking course ideal to get the Cisco CCNA certification. If you are interested, just watch the second video of this course. Well, that's it for today. Thank you for your time. If you appreciate my work, give me a like. If you adore it, subscribe.
Well, see you soon, my dear. Peace.